We have sold over $1,000 worth of products in the last 2 days. Can't believe it. I don't know how we got here, but let's go see what we sold. All right, so our sales have been what I would consider booming. I mean, they've been going pretty good. So I'm gonna very quickly go over some of the sales and talk a little bit about where I got the items from. I'm not gonna go into too much detail because I don't want to bore you guys with showing you our sales. But I did want to I want to show you that our portfolio of items come from all different types of, you know, sourcing strategies. So liquidation pallets, mystery boxes, box lots, and of course my latest craze, which is the bin store. So let's jump to the first item. The first item is a stainless steel two-tier Lazy Susan turntable. We took offer for $22. This is on a bulk.com pallet, so I can only imagine that we paid between $7 and $15 for that. Generally, when I get a bulk.com pallet, that's what I try to stick. That's the range that I try to stick into, is between that $7 and $15 range per item. So, overall, not really a big, huge moneymaker, but we stopped, tracking each load because, so if you have a bunch of different places that you get stuff from and, you know, you source from bin stores and mystery boxes and liquidation pallets, it can get cumbersome to track each load. So what we did is we track it based on how many items we list that week. So we have a goal every week for how many items we want to list, and we list that many items and we try to sell a comparable amount, or, you know, we track how much we sell based on how many items we listed for that week. And you know, these sales are not all from stuff that I listed last week. Some of these items are stuff that's been in our store for a long time, but you can kind of trick eBay by listing strategically, you know. So if you don't have like a lot of inventory, like, you know, you're just going to get one mystery box or you're just going to get one liquidation pallet, you know, just stretch out your listings over a period of time. You don't have to list everything right then, even though I know you want to get your money back. But you know, if you get 50 items on a liquidation pallet, you know, maybe you list 5 items one day and then 3 items the next day and then 4 items the next day and then 7 items the next day. And instead of doing all of your 50 listings in just one big, huge whop and then not have anything listed for the next 2 weeks, you know, I would strategically list just to keep your store active. All right. The next thing that we sold, this was a thermostatic brass rainfall shower system. We got this pallet locally for $250. This item right here actually paid for the entire pallet because this was the most expensive item on the pallet, but, you know, it sold for how much we paid for the pallet. They actually paid for shipping as well. I believe it's going to California. They asked a couple questions before. That was really nice. So hopefully they get it and are very happy with it. The next item that we sold was a joist hanger. It was an 8-pack. I think we got this from a Home Depot pallet eons ago. We ain't got a Home Depot pallet in so long, so I know this has been listed on our store for a very, very long time. But we took an offer for $21. I would imagine that we only paid $3 to $5 for this item. Those Home Depot pallets normally have a huge quantity of items in it, so and those pallets don't really cost that much. I think we only paid between like $200 and $300 for those pallets. The next item is a Bluetooth car receiver kit. I would imagine this came from a mystery box, but I'm not entirely sure exactly which mystery box it came from. But we took an offer for $18 plus shipping. So this is shipped first class. This is a very, very small box. And, you know, we'll make at least, I don't know, $10 on it, something like that, maybe. All right, the next thing that we sold was a Sadie's channel virtual surround sound USB gaming system. So system, it's it, not a system. I'm pretty sure we got this from a King Kong deal box, you know, around Christmas time. So we've had this for quite a while. In those boxes, we was around the $3 to $7 range for each item. So we'll just say $5 we paid for this. We sold it for $17.99 plus shipping. So not too bad. It has set for quite a while, but you know, it's gone now. The next item that we sold was a single cup coffee brewer. It does do K-cups. And I remember this is from a bin store. I think I got this from Gimme a Five down in Dalton. But April was telling me that, you know, these off-brand kind of coffee brewers brew really slowly. So I paid $5 for this. And we sold it for $23 plus shipping. So that's a pretty good little penny, like Ella would say. The next item is a butane cutlery torch without the gas. The gas is not included. We sold this for $15.65. The reason we have weird numbers like that, like $15.65 and $23.40, is because in general, we always have some sort of markdown sale going. So if you are struggling with making sales and, you know, you want to look at some kind of ways to revamp your stores, I'm gonna give you a couple tips real quick. All right. So always run a markdown sale of varying percentages off. We run our markdown sales. It could be 7%, it can be 5%, it can be 13%. We always have a markdown sale going. It's very simple to do a markdown sale. And we generally have it going for no longer than 3 days. So that way, whenever we list it, it gives the Cassini, which is eBay's algorithm, time to kind of go through and pump your listing up. And then, you know, you kind of have arrays of impressions. And then at the end, on that last day, that third day, it'll be showing as ending soon. So it'll kind of give people an incentive to purchase before the sale ends. They can get that percentage off. So normally I do the end of our sale like in the middle of the day. That way people are actually online. It's not in the middle of the night. It's not at midnight or anything like that. You know, normally I strive for about 3:30. Is when I end our markdown sales. And what I've noticed is towards the end, we get like a kind of an influx of sales, and that lasts like 3 to 4 hours because they will see that sales ending soon. Also, I would tell you, if you have old items on your store, I have some very old items on this sold list from this week. I would take those old listings, I will end them, and then I will sell one like this. Don't relist it, sell one like this. And then that way eBay looks at it as it's a new listing. So if you don't have merchandise, like if you can't source anything for the next week or 2 weeks or a month, you can end some of your older listings and then not relist it, but sell one like this to create a brand new listing. Now it will, that will get rid of all of the data and analytics from that item. So all your views or watches or anything like that. But if it's been there for a long time, you know, you're not really losing anything by creating a new listing. You're only gaining putting that item in front of new people. So that's a little trick that we use to kind of spur sales during the week. All right, our next thing is, this was actually one of the things I got from my last week bin store trip. This was the rain dial kind of controller thing. It does not have like the little key in it. It's like a little plastic key that goes with it, and I put that in the listing. But I paid $7 for this. We sold it for $135 plus shipping. Boom, that was a pretty good one. This is going all the way to California. A lot of our high dollar items actually do go to California. I've noticed they just go to California. This box is not that big, so it's not going to cost that much to ship, but they did pay for shipping, so it's not that big a deal. All right, the next item was a pot filler faucet. I actually got this from the newest open bin store. So I paid $8 for this item. It was we sold it for $127.89 plus shipping. This was actually one of the ones that kind of I don't know. I was thrown off by it because I saw it. I got it. It was stainless steel. It looked really nice, but I didn't realize it was $100 and something. So I remember the day that I got this, I went to the bin store and I left and I didn't check any comps on it. I just grabbed it. And when I was in the car, I was at the barbecue joint and I scanned the barcode. And I seen it was $100 and something and I had to text April real quick to tell her. So the next thing that we sold was this USB-C Pro dock. I got this last week as well. This is $7. We sold it for $120 plus shipping. The next item was a Impal wired. Why am I clapping? Impal wire foldable USB headset. I always get the Impal headsets when I go to the bin store because I don't know, they just sell, you know. I did put on here that it has some box damage, but the headphones inside are actually brand new. It just has some box damage from being inside of the bins. So we paid, you know, either $5 or $7 for this item, sold it for $18. The next item was a Delta Simplicity 20-inch handle with knobs. We sold this for $29.14. I got this from the men's store, so it was probably either $5 or $7. I can't remember if I got this on a Friday, Saturday or Sunday. But we sold it for $29 plus shipping, so we should get around, I don't know, around $20 for this item. And this, if you notice anything, all these items was actually sold from our markdown sale. So you'll see like the save up to, I think this we had 13% off. So it seems like a lot when you think about, oh, 13%, but in reality, it's not really that much, not really that much money, especially because, you know, we are getting the items in and out. So the next thing was a Hello Baby monitor wireless camera system. The screen on this one was actually broken, but the cameras did actually work. So we sold this for parts only for $8.69 plus shipping. Not a huge money maker, but we didn't lose money. I did get this out of the bins, and I just didn't, you know, of course, didn't test it before I left the bin store. The next item was a Disney Baby Winnie the Pooh. This is actually the last Winnie the Pooh plush that we have. We had like, I don't know, 10 or 12 of these, but we took an offer for $7.82 plus shipping. Not gonna make a ton of money from this, but this was from a baby palette that we got. I don't know, this was last year sometime, a long time ago, but we had so many items in that baby palette, and we was in a profit very quickly. So every time we sell one of these one-off baby items from that palette, it's just money in our pocket because we're already in the profit zone for that palette. The next thing, the next and last, the final item was the Thin, P-H-I-N, water care monitor. We actually sold two of the three. I got three of these last week, and we've sold two of them. We sold it for $120 plus shipping. It is going to California as well. This one didn't sell with the promotion, so we don't have to pay a promotion fee on this one. But the guy did send me a message before he purchased it, and he was wanting to get like some clarification on it. So anytime somebody sends you a message on eBay, just make sure you respond back to them as quickly as you can. I mean, I understand we've got stuff going on, but the quicker that you can respond to somebody, the more apt they are to purchase something from you. So I'll answer his questions. He paid immediately, and it's going to go out tomorrow. So that is all of our sales. I hope you enjoyed this little video. I just want to give you all some like tips and tricks and stuff of, you know, how to spur some sales, because we get that question so many times about people having an eBay store and just not able to make the sales. You know, they're not making sales. So these are things that we do. There are weeks that we don't, you know, our sales are like way down, our impressions are way down, and these are things that we do to spur those sales, to have good weekends like we just had this weekend. So without further ado, if you like these types of videos, please like, share, and subscribe. Really appreciate it. Also hit the bell icon so you get notifications whenever we release new videos, and we will see you guys on the next one. Peace.